Currently, the app shows dummy data that was hard-coded into the XML file. Let's make the actual weather data appear on screen using the forecast adapter. For now, we'll use the same layout for all list items, but we'll incorporate the today XML layout in the next video. Conceptually, the forecast adapter manages the logic so that for each row in the cursor, we create a corresponding list item. Think back on the explanation in lesson 1 about the array adapter, except instead of the data source being an array, now the data source is a cursor from the database. The layout for the list item is defined in the list item forecast XML file. For one row of the cursor, we're going to go through and extract out the values. We call it binding the data to the views because we take the value in each column and we set it onto a different view. For example, the high temperature value will be set onto the high temperature text view. The low temperature value will be set onto the low temperature text view. For the next row, we bind the data in the same way until we create a list item for each row in the cursor. Currently, our code defines ForecastAdapter as extending from the CursorAdapter class. If you look at the documentation for CursorAdapter, you'll notice that it's an abstract class. There are two abstract methods that we need to override: bindView and newView. The newView method returns a new list item layout, but it has no data in it. The bindView method takes an existing list item layout and updates it with the data from the cursor. In the ForecastAdapter class, in the newView method, we inflate the list item forecast XML layout. Then in the bindView method, we bind the data from the cursor to the individual views. For example, from the cursor, we read out the weather description. Then we have to go through the view hierarchy to find the text view that has the ID list item forecast text view. Once we find the text view, then we can update it with the right description. We've provided a gist below of the bindView method to get you started, but we left some to-dos for you to handle. We've provided a gist of code for the bindView method to help you get started, but we left some to-dos in there for you to do. In the gist, we also included some helper methods and strings for date formatting. That's because in our current implementation, all the dates are displayed in the same way. In the wireframes, though, we have a more friendly date format, such as today, tomorrow, Wednesday, Thursday, etc. Here's the logic for what the helper method does to get the friendly date string. If it's this week, it says today or tomorrow or the day of the week. If it's more than a week out, then we use the format Monday, June 8th, and so on. After you compile and run the app, the actual weather forecast data should now be showing in the app, and it's using a more friendly date format. Check these boxes when you're done.